I think we're going to embrace an internet of money. There are some people who feel that cryptocurrencies are going to evolve around a certain standard, and it's almost going to be like the TCIP or something, the IP of cryptocurrencies, and one token will rule them all. But it seems to me, with projects like R3Sev, with what the Linux Foundation is doing, and just the over 1,000 altcoins that exist, rather we're going to see regional application-specific currencies evolving, where each and every one of them has a constituency and a user group, and it's much more important to talk about the connection points between them, moving value and information trustlessly between these currencies. And each currency will ascribe to a particular philosophy. Some will be more anonymous than others, some will be optimized for particular performance in a certain domain. That's really exciting because you get to see many models and philosophies concurrently, especially in monetary policy, and you get to actually see if these work or not. You know, monetary policy in general is an interesting field where most decisions are made in the years and decades, and we don't really understand if they were good or bad decisions for 50 years or 60 years when we're doing a retroactive analysis. With this new Internet of Money philosophy, you can test hundreds of paradigms concurrently and within years, or some cases even months, get empirical data whether they work or not. So I think that it's created a phenomenal conversation. It's going to reinvent the way money works, but then the next phases will be reinventing the way commerce and relationships work, and then the next stage will be the fundamental reinvention of governance. And all of these things will be discovered in the matter of months and years.